First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Farooq and his channel SportsTrend for inviting us here. And I would like to share some views regarding the 50+ World Cup. Before that, I would like to give an introduction for our association, which was held in early 2017. And it was started by our 7 members. And our first tour was of Pakistan, where we played about 8 matches in Karachi only, and I mean, it was a very nice tour. Some good players were tested there, and we approached several different community players also, but due to some reasons they could not go. And our second tour was held in 2018. It was of Karachi and Lahore, and we played about 7 matches there, and we won 2 matches there. So I mean, it's a long journey, and it started in 2017. As I played about in Dubai, in Karachi, in Canada, quite a lot of senior cricket there. And I mean, I've seen some very good players here also. So I thought that we should make a good team, and I mean, have some fun. As you know, this game of cricket is basically for youngsters. So I mean, competing with them, it's a bit hard, you can say. So I thought that why not we should make a senior team here, and we can enjoy with our own same age group. So I mean, that's the reason that we are united here. The main thing was that I mean, in seniors cricket, you can show your ability with your own same age group people. So we formed a team here. And last year we played a tournament of seniors cricket also, in which 5 teams were present, and it was a very good tournament, which was held at Go Green Cricket Ground, and we were sponsored by Yashi and obviously Go Green. It was under floodlights, and we had about 5 to 6 games there, and everything was fantastic, the ground, and everybody enjoyed it. Now I would like to say regarding the World Cup, Mr. Asadul Zaman, who approached the seniors cricket Australia there, and then we thought that why not we should make a team of 50+ and go there and play cricket. So I would like to tell Asad now to say something about that.
My name is Asad. I've been with the organization for a couple of years, from the inauguration 17 toward was part of the tour, 2 tours we did, and had a great time. While we were there this year in Feb, that's when we found out that there is a 50+ World Cup being happening, or inaugural World Cup being happening in Australia in November from
Fawad Ejaz Khan.
Fawad Ejaz Khan, the president of PVCA, Pakistan Veterans. And that's when I had in mind that, okay, why don't we approach and see if they can accept Canadian contingent in their tour. So later on I found out that at this moment they only have 6 teams, and they were looking for a couple of new to make an 8-team tournament. So at the end we were accepted, and then basically they wanted to make sure that we have a good solid team that would compete against the test playing countries, and that's when we had in mind that, okay, how do we approach and get the old guy, not the old guys, the Canadian, old Canadian players who have stopped playing. So that's when we end up thinking of, okay, let's have some trials, open trials, and that's how we ended up finding new talent over 50. And tournament basically is 6 test playing countries and 2 non-test playing, which is Canada and Wales. The 6 are Pakistan, West Indies, England, Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, Sri Lanka, and I think New Zealand too. And it's a format of single league, where each team will play each other. 7 games in total will be given, and then After that, there's semifinals and finals. Even if we end up at 8th position or 7, whichever teams, they'll still have a chance to play a second level final, which will be played between the last four teams.
Mm.
And so in total, I think each team will get 9 games in total to play. Within the tournament starts on 20th, that's when the opening ceremony, meet and greet will happen, and the actual tournament will start from 21st, and the final is on 5th. So it's a total, I think it's 17 days tour, and it's all being played at Sheffield Shield Grade A grounds, and will be played with a pink Cocobra ball during the day. It's not in floodlights. 45 overs, I think so, aside.
Yeah.
And it is being co-hosted by all the teams in such a way, because each team has to share their own expenses. So it's something that it's organized by Australian veterans, but actually being supported by all the other participants. Overall, I think that the final, they're saying that the final ending ceremony will be held at Sydney Cricket Ground, inside the cricket ground, but it's not going to be played there. So you'll get a chance to be inside the ground and maybe get a chance to meet some of the good players or recent players of Australian. So now I think that that's all from me. And I'll ask
Mr. Humayu to,
talk about our trials and how we ended up with the last 16.
For sure, absolutely. Yeah. So my name is Humayu Wahab, and I have been with the Seniors Cricket Association since the beginning as well. And it is absolutely a privilege to be at the forefront of making this whole thing happen in Sydney, Australia. So before I go further into this, I'd like to sincerely extend my thanks to Mr. Nasir Mahmood of Yashi Cricket Sports, Sports Cricket. He has the best indoor cricketing facility from an indoor practicing perspective, and we would sincerely like to thank him. We'd also like to thank Mr. Gokul Kamath of BEDCL, as well as Mr. Prem Prasad of BEDCL for their unconditional support. And we would also like to thank Mr. I would like to thank Stigix for providing us with the practice balls that we used for trials. Oh. And last but not least, I would like to thank Mr. President of... President of Cricket Panel.
Ranjit Saini.
Sorry about that. So I'd like to sincerely extend my gratitude to Mr. Ranjit Saini of his guidance as well as we got upon this journey of our selections as well. So speaking of selections, it took us about 30 days or about a month to put together this team of 16. We started off with 56 players, give or take. And the response that we had in terms of participation for trials was phenomenal. I mean, we all have heard at some point in time in our lives that age is just a number, but I have witnessed it as we went through these trials that these individuals who are 50 and over, the passion that they demonstrated and the commitment that they demonstrated was second to none. I mean, we have under 19 team, we have a Canadian national team as well, and now we have this senior cricket team as well who is going to represent Canada at this World Cup. I mean, the passion is almost similar, and the willingness to go and participate and win is identical as well. So huge congrats to the 16. From a process perspective, I mentioned that we started our journey 30 days ago, so about a month ago. We started off practicing at indoor net facility, Yashi Sports again, where 56 people showed up. And we narrowed it down to about give or take 35 people. And then from that point onwards, we held two different practice games on the field. So one on the artificial turf and one on the actual turf. proper turf, and thanks to Mr. Roy for arranging that. We truly do appreciate that. And so, you know, it was a tough decision. I mean, the participation that we had ex-players of Canadian cricket who have represented Cricket Canada back in time, national cricket team. And we had one of the seniors, international cricket players as well, who have played in Pakistan as well. He has also coached the Canadian under 19 team in some capacity as well. So we got really excited when we saw that turnover. It was a very difficult selection, but we were able to narrow it down to 16. I like to call it Sweet 16. I keep on mentioning this to these guys on WhatsApp group. So the Sweet 16. One thing that I also like to bring to your attention is that, you know, Canada is all about multiculturalism. And when I see across these 16 people, I see representation from almost all around the world where cricket is being played. We have a very good bunch of players from a multiculturalism perspective as well. And I would like to wish all of them congratulations, first of all, for being selected, and then all the very best to them through the journey of this World Cup. And I cannot wait to be on board with you guys in the next few months at this World Cup. And with that, I would like to hand it over to Mr. Adnan Khan, who is going to reveal the 16 players who we have selected.
Thanks, Umayu. Like Umayu said, like we had like a 50 guys, so it was very tough to select, but we all have to accept reality. So we are going to announce CSEA 16 members of team: Talal Iqbal, Farooq Kirmani, Rohan Jayasekhara, David Mohammed, Mahmood Ahmed, Vishan Dimal, Puri Ravi Shankar, Roy Singh, Brian Raja Aduri, Vincent Correla, Abhilash Patel, Javed Qureshi, Rudy Gibson, Shanta Jayasekhara, Sayyed Rafiullah, and Asad Khan. With that, we have some of reserve players.
Four.
Which are all together is four. So, Mazam Jamal, Kanti Patel, Gokul Kemat, and Tariq Yusuf. So, after that, we have like some supporting staff is going as well with the 50 plus team. So, Dean Fernandez as a team manager, Adnan Khan as a scorer, and Tumayu Wahab, publicity officer. In 16 members of team, we also announced the captain. Captain will be Talal Iqbal, and vice captain would be Asad Khan. So I would like to say something, Talal.
Yeah, it's a very good team. As you can see, some excellent players from Toronto, Canada. We have here, like Mr. Farooq Bhai. I mean, I've been here for 7 years, and I've been told that Farooq Bhai is here for almost 30-35 years, and he's been playing cricket since. I mean, he used to play with Javed Miandad, one of the biggest name of Pakistan cricket, and I mean, he has been playing here and scoring centuries and scored a lot of runs in Toronto and definitely on other tours outside Canada. And we have here also Mr. Rohan Jayasekhara, a big name of cricket in Canada, and he had played against Pakistan in 1982 in test cricket. As I've said earlier, they are very good cricketers. I mean, all of them. I mean, now this is an opportunity, and it's a dream come true at this age. At 50 plus, we'll be going, inshallah, to play the World Cup. And I hope, and I really hope that this bunch of cricketers, as Umayyan told, that we have 56 players here. and we have cut down to 16. And I'm telling you, it was very difficult. Some very good players we had to left. I mean, it was tough, and the selection was transparent and fair. And I really hope that this team will do good, definitely. And I mean, I really thank again to all of you who have participated in the trials and now who are in the team. So I mean, that's great. And Farooq Bhai, we have decided that Farooq Bhai will be coach of this Canadian cricket team and as a player also. Definitely, we need his guidance. He is a terrific player. He knows the ins and outs of cricket, and he will be an asset to the team, definitely. I would like to thank again Mr. Farooq and his channel Sports Trends, and they are doing a tremendous job regarding local cricket in Canada.